The only comfort that we've had was to know that he could not hurt us or our family, and that's the only peace of mind that we have found. And we're just here to ask that you don't take that from us.
I've lived in a lot of fear. I have a problem with black people. I'm scared of them.
You're not scared of me this morning, are you?
No, I wouldn't be alone with you either. It happened, 20 years ago. 20 years means nothing to me. That's yesterday to me.
I got two grandbabies, both of them girls. One's 5 and one's 2. And I was just sitting here thinking and looking at you all. I don't know what I would do if something like that would happen to my grandbabies.
This board is very sympathetic to you. You can rest assured that this board's going to do its duty. I don't have nothing to say to him, but I'd like to hear what he says.
I'm going
to
hear what he says. I'm going to question ask him.
Mr. Simmons, come here and have a seat.
All right.
Good morning. Would you answer Mr. Magrie's questions?
You committed these two rapes?
No, sir. What'd you say?
No, sir.
Tell me what happened.
I had newly discovered evidence because I've been trying to get the evidence since I've been here to prove my innocence.
You pled guilty?
No, sir. Okay. And they told you, say that they wanted me to make a confession. And I told them that I wasn't going to make a confession because I was innocent. One of the officers hit me. And when I tried to jump up, the other officer jumped up and he shot me in the police station.
Their version is you grabbed a pistol and you tried to kill them. And you kept pulling the trigger and it wouldn't go off, and another officer came in and shot you.
I was never charged with that crime. They tried to justify shooting me.
Unfortunately, if the officer wanted to kill you, he wouldn't have shot you.
He shot me right above the heart. We didn't have none of this evidence. None of this evidence was presented before the jury because the DA had it in his files. And in these files, the doctor's report indicated that the girls were virgins. Say why?
You have those reports where the doctor said that there was a virgin? I'd like to see it.
They testified before the jury that they were brutally raped. They repeatedly asked them, would they be able to identify this person again if they saw him? They say no, because all blacks look alike.
They put you in line up and they said they all picked out the man.
No, when they brought me in, I was handcuffed.
You were the only one handcuffed in the lineup?
I'm the only one.
Okay, if y'all step out, we'll discuss the case. Book on it after you get to the office. He did it. He just didn't. You know, I have a... Mr. Simmons, after listening to testimony and going over the reports, the board has voted at this time to deny your request for parole, and certainly you have a right to pursue your case through the United States Supreme Court, and I certainly would do that. You know, that's your legal right.
So, two twins went inside the police station, and when they got there, they made a claim, an alleged claim. They said, hey, police officers, we have just gotten raped. The officers in turn asked them, can you give us a description of who committed this alleged rape? They said, hey, it was a black man. They said, that is not enough. Give us more. They said, hey, officers, we don't know. All blacks look alike. Right after that, the officers went outside. The first black man they saw, which was a young man named Vincent Simmons, they spoke to him, they apprehended him, they took him to the precinct. Right when they took him to the precinct, they put handcuffs on him and they put him straight into a lineup. He was the only person in the lineup with handcuffs on. While he was in the precinct, the officer, another officer, took a gun and shot him in the chest. Come to find out, this officer that did the shooting was a cousin of one of the twins. However, the medical report came out. The medical report came out that one of the twins was actually a virgin. However, the DA withheld this evidence from trial. Now, the case of Vincent Simmons has so many flaws, and it shows that justice is not being served. And I take this case very personal because Vincent Simmons can be you, and he can also be me. It's 2014, and we need to make a change happen. We need to bring justice. On October 13, 2014, the city of Marksville in Louisiana, we are having a march to march for Vincent Simmons, to bring a light to this dark case, to bring justice to this case. Do the research. Google about Vincent Simmons. Wikipedia about Vincent Simmons. The facts of this case will show you that this crime allegedly never took place, and all the evidence will point to you that Vincent Simmons indeed is an innocent man. Vincent Simmons is currently locked up and is serving 2 counts of 50 years. For what? For a crime that he never committed. Join us with this march. Do some research. Google, Wikipedia, anything you can do, and I guarantee you that the facts of this case will show that Vincent Simmons is an innocent man. Join us in this march. Thank you.